He's a real nowhere man, sitting in his nowhere land, making all his nowhere plans for nobody. Doesn't have a point of view, knows not where he's going to. Isn't he a bit like you and me? Nowhere man, please listen, you don't know what you're missing. Nowhere man, the world is at your command. Blind as he can be, just sees what he wants to see. Nowhere man, can you see me at all? Nowhere man, don't worry, take your time, don't hurry, leave it all to somebody else. Lends you a hand, doesn't have a point of view, knows not where he's going to. Isn't he a bit like you and me? Nowhere man, please listen, you don't know what you're missing. Nowhere man, the world is at your command. He's a real nowhere man, sitting in his nowhere land, making all his nowhere plans. Making all his nowhere plans for nobody. Making all his nowhere plans for nobody.
Isn't that good? That's Paul Westerberg. Now, that's a song that probably...
Absolutely.
Excuse me, there are people talking here. That's a cover of Nowhere Man. And the reason I played that is because yesterday, as you probably know, was the 30th anniversary of John Lennon's death. It was very death. It was very surprising, wasn't it? There was very little on terrestrial television last night about that.
I think it got the coverage it deserved, if you know that. I don't mean that in a cold-hearted way. No, it was on the national news at the end of the
news. No, but there were no programmes.
What do you want?
I want programmes. I mean, 30th anniversary, that's quite significant, and a cultural figure. You know, and there's been a major movie out called Nowhere Boy. Did you see it?
No.
No, you see, you don't know. And it was a very good movie. I went to see that.
No,
I thought I'd maybe write the balance today. You know what I'm going to do today as a kind of a different thing? I have got the greatest collection of Beatles covers that any white man has. And I'm going to play some of the more unusual ones today. I've got about 150 of them here. I'm going to just play, just sprinkle them about, just to do something different, you know. I know you'd be playing your own usual stuff today, Dave D, Dozy, Beaky McIntitch, and Zabadak, you know. But to me, I think it's important that I do something a little different. So what we're going to do, we'll do that today. That's a fellow called Paul Westerberg. That's a song called Nowhere Man.
It was all right, you know, Nowhere Man. Nowhere Man was good. When we came in here to the studio, you were already playing it. And so we missed a bit of it. And I said to Emma, that's nice. That's very unusual. And I said to the undertone, I said, that's nice. And he says, nah. So
I started to
listen to it. Yeah, the only thing I thought against it was it went on too long.
Oh, it was a whole 2 minutes long.
It was too long. No, but it sounded longer.
90 seconds?
It sounded longer. I think he dragged the drawers.
No, one of the things about songs like that, and I have always thought this about various other songs, sometimes it's better when a person sings a song who doesn't have a particularly good voice, and then you're not distracted by the good voice and you just listen to the words. Sometimes that was Percy French's theory. Whenever he wrote all the songs, like, I feel the flutter pattin' in the toll the belly buck. He didn't like people who were singing them who were baritones or tenors or had good voices or operatic voices. He liked the people who sing songs who had no voice at all.
You didn't know that Paddy Riley was a real person, a true.
I knew that.
You did not.
I did know.
You
that.
Did not.
I did know.
You did
I
not.
I knew, I said.
You didn't know.
I knew. Because I knew. Listen, never you mind that.
I know.
Terrible,
you know.
Terrible news. Let me just introduce the people to the programme because they'll be wondering what this programme is all about, as indeed I often do myself. Good morning, ladies and gentlemen, people who are listening out there. The number to ring if you want to contact this programme is 08459 555678. Email address is jerry.anderson@bbc.co.uk and the text messaging service if you wish to avail of the text, and every once in a while I look at them. It's 81771. Bad news. Did you hear that Al-Qaeda had been rumoured to be targeting Coronation Street? Did you read that? They could hardly do any more damage than they did themselves. On Monday night, a very revealing and insightful article in today's wonderful Belfast Telegraph written by Julian Simmons. And he says, I've heard that Rita survives, which I hope is true. And I really, really want baby Jack to survive too. I don't want to see anything happening to the baby. My bets would be on poor Molly and Sunita as the two who die, but the one character I'd like to see the back of is Auntie Pam with her basket of sandwiches. She turns me on. My night's off on Monday. I've been able to watch a few episodes. What an insightful article that is. I recommend everyone to read it.
Did it not happen, the big crash?
That's what I'm talking about. It happened on Monday night.
And why are we still talking about it on Thursday? Why do they not know who's survived this crash?
Because it's a cliffhanger. It's a cliffhanger.
But does it not on last night?
I know, but they don't know who's dead yet. My guess, it ended last night with, what do you call him, Leslie or Wesley? What do you call little fire? You know, like that. Wesley, is it? The little fire. He used to be a butcher.
Is he a motor mechanic?
No, he used to be a butcher, I said.
Is he the boy that had, whose wife had a baby to the motor mechanic?
No, that's a different guy. That's Kevin. No, it's
no.
That's a Todd or somebody. Look, stop it, will you?
No,
I don't know the names of any
of
them.
Please tell me who Wesley is.
Wesley's the wee fellow who used to be a butcher, and he talks like an old man.
Had he a granda?
Ashley.
Ashley, the big man.
Ashley's the small man. He used to work for a man who used to say, I don't know that. Remember, he used to work for him. Anyway, listen, let's not get bogged down here.
Where's the big boy?
I don't know. Jesus buys, says a man called Anthony. Wasn't Geordie spot on with his prediction of a severe winter?
We have to talk to Geordie today.
I know. And do you know how spot on he was? It was minus 10 degrees during the daytime here in Glasgow, and the snatters were tripping me as I hot-footed it through the streets. I didn't think anybody else said hot-footed it except Radio Ulster presenters. I'm hot-footing it down to the scene of the crash. Well done to Geordie and his predictions. Does he only do the weather? No, he also does drink. And here's a lady in distress. Veronica says, so sorry to trouble you, but we need your help to find the owner of a small white puppy which was found in the Money Stag Inn forest outside Claddy last Saturday. My son and brother-in-law found it. My brother-in-law has tried to find out from the locals who it belongs to, but as yet no one has come forward to claim it. We think it's a Samoyed breed, but not sure. One of them is exotic dogs. We would like to return it to its owner, as I'm sure someone is looking for this lovely puppy. So there we are. And here's a person who said, I've just been watching BBC Newsline. Oh, hot-footed it to the television to turn it on. They were talking about growing vegetables in this cold weather. One farmer was covering his parsnips with straw to protect them. But then they showed how sprouts have big leaves to do the job naturally. See, sprouts are no fools. Sprouts knew the score. They showed boys reaping the sprouts, and a farmer said it wasn't so pleasant for the pickers, but that, he said, it's like the man milking the cow. You have to make hay while the sun shines. I had trouble keeping up with that.
I want to ask you this.
Go ahead. Ask me anything. You know, you can ask me anything.
Because you're a wee bit of a country boy, right? No, but you are. Right.
Yeah, I am indeed, yes. Agriculture blood flows in my veins.
What do sprouts look like in the field?
They're a big stick.
Are they?
Yeah, they're a big stick and they hang on. It's like a Christmas tree. Do you never see a sprout on the stick?
No.
On the stem?
See,
on the stalk?
I don't eat sprouts, so I wouldn't
know. I know, but
know
if you never see them, you don't have to eat them to see them.
So they grow out like strawberries?
Like a tree.
Do they?
Yes, they do.
And you, do you pick them off the trees?
I don't know.
Well, you said they grew up.
No, they grow up. I don't know if they grow on the ground or they grow down. I don't know if they grow up or down. I really don't know.
So you don't know either?
Here's a man complaining about... Oh, no, it's not him at all. Here's a Christmas message. A person wants me to read this out. I can't believe it's that time of year again, says this young lady. I always write to you at this time of the year on behalf of my mother. Her name is Molly McFlynn. She is a wonderful lady. She has so many friends and family. She finds it difficult to be sent to send cards to everyone. So instead, she gives money to charity. Her charity is Children Caught in Crossfire. And makes the request through you to say to all her friends and family, have a wonderful Christmas and a happy new year. But you can be quiet, please, whilst I'm reading this. Molly
Emma,
is a very...
Emma has shown me her sprouts.
Is she?
Oh, look. Yeah.
I like a sprout every now and again. Maybe she'll show them to me later.
They're up
so,
on screen.
What?
They're up on Emma's screen.
Are they?
Yes.
So indeed, she gives money to charity. Molly is a very active lady for all her 83 years old, always on the go, or as my brother says, she's like the white lion on the road. She's never off it. But this year, she had to have a hip operation, but thank God, she's back on her feet. She's been staying with my sister and her family, the McGeehans, Emilian, John and family, who've been looking after her like a china doll. Molly has been stuck indoors with this weather and missing out badly on her Wednesday nights in the country house, The Loop, where Tilly McVeigh puts on a great traditional musical evening. Your friend Sean Donnelly appeared in the country house one night some time ago. He is a very nice man. Tilly put up a great country welcome and food, lots of singers and musicians, too many to mention. But hopefully, if the snow goes away, we will get together before Christmas in case we don't see each other. From Molly and all her daughters, happy Christmas. See you in the new year. And that lady describes herself as one of Molly's daughters. It's good to be able to impart a personal message. You know, I worry about you because you have no feelings. Dante wrote, said Adam, abandon all hope, ye who enter here. A similar message is inscribed above the main door into the BBC. This is a man who's complaining about people in Oma. I hesitate to read this, but warts and all. Referring, of course, to Hades. If he were around today, he'd inscribe it above Oma's bars on a Saturday night. I've gone there for a night of culture and sophistication, aided by freshly ironed shirts, nice shoes, smart jackets, and half a bottle of jupe splashed around my jollops. What a waste of time. The town is haunted by Philistines, who view me like an inhabitant of Jupiter. If you can't beat them, join them. So next time I go in there, I'm going to put on wrinkled jeans, industrial boots, and football hooligan-style sweatshirts. Also, I'll foot it with a big end to get that encrusted black powder right under my fingernails. I won't shave for 4 days. Perhaps then I'll be embraced to the collective bosom. It pains me to slander my environment. It's lack of bohemians and antiquity. But I imagine that fine dining and haute cuisine would be eschewed in favour of a bathtub full of baked beans garnished with a couple of dead dogs. That's a man who's very, very embittered by the standard of cultural activity he sees around him. And I myself cannot say anything one way or the other because I would be shown to be taking sides. Yes?
Could you give details of The Road Goes On Forever? A lady was...
Well, the particular version that I played yesterday is called Live at the Ryman.
Live at the Ryman.
Yes. Right. Live at the Ryman.
Live at
you know
the
what the Ryman is, don't you?
No, tell me.
You don't know what the Ryman is?
No.
And you're a man who does a music programme, you don't know what the rhyme
is. Tell me.
It's the Grand Old Opry.
You told me that the other day.
Why didn't you remember that?
Because
I can't remember.
I can't.
Okay, it's Live at the Ryman, and that's all you need to know. But that's not the definitive version of that song. The definitive version of that song is out there in the ether, and someone I know is going to send it to me soon. There's a man who's actually promised to send it to me, a man who gave it to me in the first place, and he has not come through.
You were in the Old Opry, weren't you?
Yes, a number of
times.
Were
you impressed with it?
I was very impressed.
It doesn't look very impressive from what you see on TV.
Well, you see, when you see it on TV, you don't get the atmosphere.
Yeah, yeah.
May I say two words to you?
Yes.
Do you really want me to? No, may I say a number of words to you? May I mention two venues to you?
Right.
Grand Opera House.
Right.
Right? St. Columb's Hall in Derrystoke, Londonderry.
Yes.
What have those two places got that nowhere else has?
Slanted stage.
Yes, and a patina of age and history. A patina of age and history is not a thing you can paint on with a brush. You get all your community centres, all your new halls, all your community halls, all your cross-community buildings, all that stuff. People sitting in little chairs looking around them saying, is he a Protestant, is he a Catholic? What's he doing here? Is there any drink? That bar, you can't get a drink here. You can look at all that. But see, when you go into one of the old places and you feel the history, do you realise that Caruso sang in the Grand Opera House in Belfast? Do you realise that Jim Reeves died? He died in a plane crash. Jim Reeves died in St. Columb's Hall because the piano didn't tune.
It wasn't in St. Columb's Hall.
Where was it then?
It was in Lifford, I think it was.
Are you telling me that Jim Reeves didn't appear in St. Columb's Hall?
He did appear in St. Columb's Hall, but everything was perfect. There's no problems. He had been down at a storm.
Were you there, were you?
I know the man that brought him.
The man that brought him?
The man that promoted the show.
Okay.
Told the story of it.
So it was in Lifford, in County Donegal.
I think it was. It certainly wasn't in St. Columb's.
But the piano was out of tune, he wouldn't sing.
All that's greatly exaggerated, by the
way. All right, okay. Mm-hmm. What am I, an oracle? I'm just talking off the top of my head here. Why must you correct me every single thing I say? No, the Grand Old Opry, I remember being in the back of the Grand Old Opry, and I was standing in the stairwell talking to Nancy Griffiths and Hal Ketchum. And do you know
right?
who came? Do you know who came along?
Dean Martin?
No, Brad Paisley. And do you know what he said? How are you doing, young Anderson? Is everything all right?
Listen, talking of words, two words. I was watching the snooker last night.
How amazing.
Yes, and Dennis Taylor was commentating on a game. Oh, it was a very, very...
Are you talking? Listen, what's that? Sean Connery is on here.
But it was Dennis Taylor, and it was just a gripping encounter, you see.
Did he get in off the blue?
No, but he was saying, he was talking to, I think, Steve Davis or Ken Doherty, whoever was his fellow commentator.
Yes.
And he said, he was describing the game being a great battle. And he says, Ken, there's only one word describes it, true grit.
That's a great word. I should put those together.
There are places I'll remember all my life. Though some have changed, some forever, not for better. Some have gone and some remain. All these places have their moments, with lovers and friends I still can recall. Some are dead, and some are living. In my life, I've loved them all. Friends and lovers, there is no one compares with you. And these memories lose their meaning when I think of love as something new. Though I know I'll never lose affection for people and things that went before. I know I'll often stop and think about them. In my life, I'll love you more. In my life, I'll love you more.
That's Sean Connery, of course, in my life. Not only was that man singing yesterday a bit out of tune, there was a record I played yesterday, I can't remember the man's name, Corb Lund. He was singing a song called, what was it? He was playing the guitar, I can't remember what it was. But he didn't really know the words either. I was tittering away, but who needs words? One night at a party, there was a guy with a guitar. My sister and I are the main singers, with her doing the melody and me harmonising. We're very good, even if I do say so myself. As the man said, I don't like to blow my own trumpet, not with my back. After House of the Rising Sun and American Pie and all that stuff, we were running out of songs. The guitar player started playing Won't You Come Home, Bill Billy. My sister and I took over. We hadn't a clue of the words. All we sang was Won't You Come Home, Bill Billy? Won't you come home, Bill Billy? Won't you please come home? We repeated those lines over and over again. It lasted for 20 minutes and people said it was absolutely brilliant. In fact, the best song of the night. You know, people have been known to sing Bill Billy for nearly an hour and a half because you don't need to know the words. And here's a very sad poem. I'm going to read this, and I hope you can take it. You don't need to do it. You don't need to sing that. Won't you come home, Bill Billy? Won't you come home? Won't you come home, Bill Billy? Won't you come home, Bill Billy? Won't you please come home? Won't you come home, Bill Billy? Won't you come home? She cried the whole day long. I'll do the cooking, baby. You pay the rent. That kind of stuff. Beware the man who walks alone with fearsome, brooding eyes. Just one eyebrow has this man. Some wonder if he's wise. Who is this man? This solitary man who has left hearth and home to walk the dark and grisly streets alone, alone, alone. What terrible sin is on his soul? What thoughts are in his head? Is this a living, breathing man, or is this man undead? People fly from the strange zombie and wonder where he's heading. This man seems to float in air, who whispers, stall the wedding. Is he going to the old crossroads to claim another soul from some fool with a red guitar who plays the rock and roll? Little children peer from bedrooms, their little hearts aflutter as a nocturnal Herman Munster splashes through the gutter. I fear thee, strange black walking man. I fear your jet black eye as you walk on towards the North Star, a twinkling in the sky. Are you going to the graveyard to raise your fellow ghouls with demonic incantations, the devil's black arts tools? Get back! Get back! Get back to where you once were. Get back! Get back, O man in black, return to whence you came, return to your warm coffin and play no more this evil game. Cease this restless wandering, cease, I please, plead, please, cease. O blighted, lonely, walking man, I pray that you find peace. The ghostly man keeps walking like goosey-goosey gander. It's only Sean Coyle. Out for a bit of a dander.
There's a wee call there for you, Jim.
Too late was the cry.
No, Jim.
Ah!
Jim, I was dreaming about Moby Dick last night.
Moby Dick! Aha! There she blows, aye. Captain. It's a whiten starbuck. Hello, good morning.
Good morning.
I'm sorry, I just was Captain Ahab for a moment. I don't know what came over me. I'll put the dog down, Damien. The Nantucket Sleigh Ride. Do you know what the Nantucket Sleigh Ride is?
Tell me.
Do you know what the Nantucket Sleigh Ride is?
Oh, tell us.
Now, don't be so impatient. In days of old, when knights were bold and women weren't invented, men took to the seas. It's a bad cough that man has, to turn them off. I'll be back with you in a moment, sir. Cough away. Men used to take to the seas in small open boats with no outboard motors and nothing. In the 19th century, with a harpoon, and the lead man with the harpoon would throw the harpoon into the sperm whale or the right whale. No, it was called the right whale. Do you know why it was called the right whale?
Would you tell us?
Because
why must you ask? Why didn't you just say the white whale? It was called the white whale.
No, the right whale. Right,
well, why didn't you just say it was called the right whale because...
Don't be so impatient. It was called the right whale because it was the right whale to catch. But people say that's a right whale.
Yeah, that's original.
No, the sailors used to call the right whale.
Yeah.
Because it was the right whale for the oil and all that spermicelli. Eat your spermicelli, Joe. Anyway, the man used to plunge the harpoon into the dark heart of the whale. The whale would then zoom towards the depths. The rope would be tied round a capstan, and the whale would take off, taking the boat with it, skimming the waves, the Nantucket Sleigh Ride. It's like being on a sleigh, but down a hill, skimming the top of the waves. Arr, mister.
They must have had a big, long rope.
He had a big, long rope, mister. Hello, good morning, sir. I'm sorry about all this. This seems a little deranged, I know, to you sitting at home in a normal home. How are you today?
You calm down, Jerry.
I'm okay now.
You all right?
Yeah.
Taking over volume.
No, I've really taken four.
All right, that's okay. Well,
what can we Jerry, do for you? Yes?
You see that track of the Redman?
The Ryman, yes, yes.
Yeah, well, that is definitely the wrong track.
That's
the one that you're looking for. That is definitely not.
I know it's not. It's not bad.
There's not as much audience anticipation in it.
No, the other one, the audience goes mad. The band is so good, they whip the audience into a frenzy.
Yeah. And that's the one that you like. You know, there's more anticipation in the audience. It's marvellous. But that one there that you played in the Rainman, that is definitely the wrong one.
It is the wrong one, but I thought I'd play it to show the people what the contenders are.
Yeah.
But to see when I get
where would you get the original, Jerry?
I know a man who has it. The man who sent it to me originally, he said he's got it and he said he's promised to send it to me and he hasn't sent it to me yet. And I know he's probably busy running about this Christmas time, but maybe perhaps.
But what album is that off?
I don't know. He won't tell me. Perhaps he'll find it in his heart to tell me. I will, as soon as I get it, I'll play it. I want to play it for Christmas.
Okay.
Okay then.
Thanks.
God bless you.
Bye.
Goodbye. Goodbye. Ah, into the stormy deep. Stop this. It's crazy. That's a very unusual little thing there. That's an instrumental. That's, of course, Dear Prudence by Gabor Zazro, some kind of strange guitar player. Do you like that? I thought that was really
wonderful.
Good.
Wonderful, eerie, wonderful.
Listen, yeah. There's some kind of echo here. Can you hear an echo?
Yeah, Nigel just phoned in. They say there's a lot of rustling, a lot of noise that shouldn't be heard.
Talking about the music? Well, I can understand that in a way. But there's an echo in my ear. I must try and get rid of that. There's something weird going on here. But it's okay, it's all right, I can handle it. But just everything I say is just coming back immediately, coming back to my head. You know, and it's not, I'm not used to that.
Might be a wee button on in your panel there that shouldn't be on.
Well, I'm looking for any wee button.
No, up the panel up the front there.
Up the panel up the front there.
In front of you.
I think we need Ken. Ask Ken to come in during the course of the news, will you? Because everything I say, I hear it back in my ear.
We don't
twice.
Have Ken today.
Who's in today?
Shane.
Is he any good? Get him in then. He might be able to find. At least we can trust him. At least we can maybe depend on him to try and help us rather than hinder us.
Right.
Okay. Get Ken. Get him now. Right. Get him now.
On 92-95 FM and 1341 medium wave. This is BBC Radio Ulster.
The BBC News at 11 o'clock with Sabrina Sweeney. A BBC investigation has found that 10 vulnerable children known to social services have died in Northern Ireland since 2003. Unlike the rest of the UK, reports into such deaths are not made publicly available here. Colin Reid from the NSPCC wants a change in policy.
These reports go back to 2003 when we first started doing them, and many of the people who were involved in doing them didn't anticipate they would make their way into the public domain. But I think times have changed. We've got new legislation which has gone through the Health Committee at the Assembly, creating a new safeguarding board for Northern Ireland, and we think now is the time where we could look to publish these, to give public assurance that things have been done to deal with these very tragic cases.
Ammunition, fireworks and drugs have been found by police in a house in Lurgan. Cannabis worth £1,000 was found with the explosives in Sperrin Park yesterday afternoon. A 23-year-old man was arrested during the seizure and has since been released on bail. 40 people have been arrested for burglary so far this month. Half of them have since been charged as part of the PSNI's crackdown on Christmas thieves. Dubbed Operation Season's Greetings, the police are pulling resources from different teams and departments in an attempt to stop the usual increase in burglaries at this time of year. Students from Northern Ireland are expected to join protests against plans to increase tuition fees in England. The protests coincide with today's vote on proposals at Westminster. The Labour leader Ed Miliband said Liberal Democrat MPs who are uneasy about the proposed rise should vote against the coalition.
My message to Lib Dem MPs is they made a clear promise at the general election. The only way they can fulfil that promise is by voting down these changes. Abstention is the same as voting for these changes and letting them through, and they will pay a heavy price at the next election.
And now the weather details with Cecilia Daly.
Many roads and pavements will remain icy today, but there will be a slight thaw in places too as temperatures rise to 6 degrees on the coast and 2 or 3 Celsius in rural areas. It will become increasingly cloudy with some spots of drizzle or sleet, although many places will stay dry. Tonight will be damp and misty with low cloud and fog. There will still be icy stretches, though temperatures should stay just above freezing.
BBC News.
BBC Radio Ulster. Travel news.
Well, black ice may still be a problem for drivers as rain is falling onto frozen surfaces around parts of Fermanagh and Tyrone, so drive with extreme caution. Also, icy roads are lingering around Maherfelt, Cookstown, Omagh and Ballygawley, and the Newry bypass may still be icy between Clog and Sheep Bridge. On to roadworks, and the Newton Breda Road is closed from the Purdiesburn Road down to Greer Park Avenue. That's until 4:30 tomorrow afternoon. And tonight the M1 will be closed heading into Belfast from 11pm until 6 tomorrow morning. That's from Blairis to Blacks Road, and diversions will be signposted. Anne Jordan reporting.
Travel news on BBC Radio Ulster.
On Talk Back with Wendy Austin today, enough's enough. It's time to get the army back on our streets. Will the ice and snow succeed where the dissidents failed? Northern Ireland students in London for the big fees vote today. Will the Lib Dems back them? Could Sinn Féin votes have swung the outcome? Ireland's on its uppers, we all know, but guess who's still getting the big bonuses? Yes, it's the bankers, who caused it all. And Corrie at 50, the big live programme tonight. Who've been your favourite characters in that time? And who do you think will live and die? Join the debate on Talkback at 12.
Well, the Ukraine girls really knocked me out. I leave their wares behind. lasts forever. Living is easy with your eyes closed. Misunderstanding all you see. It's getting hard to be someone, but it all works out. It doesn't matter much to me. Let me take you down.
I feel a caftan growing round my neck. That's Ben Harper. That's a song called Strawberry Fields, of course, very much a John Lennon song. That's what we're doing today. We're playing, well, not all John Lennon stuff, but as a kind of a homage to John Lennon and the Beatles. John Lennon, of course, 30th anniversary of his death yesterday. We should have done it yesterday, but I think it's better to do it the day after when people aren't fed up. Will you stop talking to me when I'm talking to the people?
No, there's a man going to lose the signal.
Good morning, signal-losing person. Good morning, how are you? Hello? Yes.
Barry here.
Yes.
See that bit of music you played before the news?
Yes.
That's very similar to another famous tune.
Hold on a minute. There's a number of things here. I hear everything you say three times. Have you have got a radio on, or are you somewhere on the outer limits of the galaxy? Where are you?
Is that better?
That's a bit better, yeah. What were you going to say?
Okay, Jerry, the piece of music you played before in the news.
Yes?
It's not an original piece of music. It's a copy piece of music.
What did I say it was?
It if they're down to go to Supertramp's Goodbye Stranger, totally the same in every respect, because I was singing the words when I was driving the truck.
Is that right? Well, it might be the same chord sequence, but I mean, you can't say it's identical. Well, I don't know. Maybe you can if you want. It's all right,
someone's
though.
Someone's copied someone else, sir.
That's all right. Don't worry about it. It's all right. It's okay. It'll be all right. But thank you for bringing that to our attention. Thank you.
Thank you.
All right, then.
I just thought I'd bring that to your attention, Jerry.
Yeah. Thank you. All right,
okay,
then.
Bye-bye.
Bye. What a riveting call that was, Sean. Thanks for insisting that went through.
No, because you were not a bit interested in that.
I couldn't hear him. It was like
We could hear him.
What did he say?
I'm not going to tell you. If you just switched off immediately.
I don't know why.
You don't know what that fella had a point to make. And you
what
you
was
said,
the point?
No, I'm not going to tell you. It was your caller.
You're not going to tell me?
No.
Go on, tell me what the point is.
It was up to you to winkle that out of him.
I couldn't winkle anything, a man. He sounded as if he was ringing from Jupiter.
Well, Steve from... wait a minute. He's been waiting to talk to you for 9 minutes.
All right, then, so I have no respect.
I said to you there's a call. She put him through, and then you went into Strawberry Fields and ignored him.
I'm sorry. Before that, we had... Incidentally, we had Back in the USSR by the Leningrad Cowboys. Hi, Jerry. Please play Paperback Writer, sung by Chris Christopherson. I don't have that. For Big Ray, Out on the Road. See you tonight, kid. Right, I have... who have I got singing Paperback Writer? The Bee Gees. Did you ever hear the Bee Gees singing to Paperback Writer?
No, but I would like to hear that.
Here it goes.
Well, wait. Sorry. let's not keep Steve from Bangor waiting. He's on too.
Okay. Good morning, Steve from Bangor.
Good morning, Jerry. How are you?
Oh, that's better. I couldn't hear the last man, which is why I kind of lost my attention.
That's okay. You probably won't want to hear me either.
No, I want to hear you. Yes, I do.
No, I want to empathise with you in so much as... people letting you down when it comes to getting a CD sent out to you.
That's not great.
You know, a copy of a bit of music that you heard.
I know.
A long time ago. It takes me back to a time, I suppose about a year ago, when it was like certain Kimmy Rhodes and Willie Nelson.
Yes.
That were singing a beautiful song called Love and Happiness.
Yes.
And a certain, I hate to use these words, DJ, as in what have you, but from Radio Fallout, promised me a copy of that said CD.
Did I ever give it to you?
No, you never did. And even, I actually phoned back and asked for a tape. If you play it, I could tape it. I have put a tape on every day since, and I've never heard the song.
Well, I'll tell you.
It cost me an absolute fortune.
May I say this to you? Last Friday on this programme, the very same person, Kimmy Rhodes, sang it live on this programme last Friday. And it's on iPlayer.
Yes, but Willie Nelson wasn't there with her.
No, he wasn't. He couldn't get in the door. Well, okay. Well, I don't think... Do I have a recording of her and Willie Nelson singing it?
Well, yes. You play it often enough.
All right, then. Well, John, will you take a note of this man's...
I'm just settling in now, is it?
Will you take note of this man's particulars?
No, I will not.
Do you hear? This is why you're not getting anything, because people here won't help me.
No. You have a pen. You have no excuse. You have
I have a pen.
Yes, you have a pen.
Am I going to ask him for his address
on
the radio and ask him to write it me?
All you have to do is say to Steve, I'll call you after the programme and get your details.
You know I don't do that.
And I'll send it out to you.
I don't ring anybody after the programme. You know that.
Well.
And don't be telling him that I do that. Why don't you ring him after the programme?
No.
It's far better.
No, because you promised Steve the CD.
It had been a rash moment. I don't know why. I might have had a rush of blood to the head. I'm sorry. Sometimes I do these things. Steve, if the people there will help...
Morning?
Because I don't think I have it. I don't remember having it. He says I have it.
You played it.
The girl sang it herself live. What more do you want? Blood? Do you want blood?
You were the first man to play that on the radio. You played that.
Tell you what I'll do, Steve. Sorry, I'm sorry I'm not waiting for Sean to finish, but I know what he's going to say. I'll tell you what I'll do. I will conduct a search for this. If I can find Kimmy Rhodes and Willie Nelson singing this alternatively together,
probably left it in the same place where you left your turkey hop.
You know about that, huh? All right, then, okay.
I was me who sent you that.
Okay, then. Right, so then, now...
That's probably why I never got the CD, by the way.
What's a turkey hat?
Never you mind this. Never you mind this. Keep out of it. I have a turkey hat.
Emma wants to know as
Emma,
well.
There are certain things that young girls should not know. And my turkey hat is indeed one of them. Details of my turkey hat. It's a very crude hat. And I don't like to talk about it, nor do I like to wear it in mixed company.
Okay.
All right, thank you very much for that, sir. You shall be ministered to.
No, before Steve goes, What's the arrangements with you and Steve?
The arrangements that he's going to talk to you.
No.
Stay
no.
on the air, Steve. No, Steve Sean will Steve, be talking Steve, to you now I'm in a not... moment, and he will talk to you and take all the... see the way I can turn everybody off. Please say happy birthday to Bertie Covell in Milisle from Anne and George at number 3 Gaudí's Terrace. Where's that? Barcelona? Please play Status Quo's It's Christmas Time for Ciara O'Neill, who is in hospital in Altnagelvin at the moment. That's from the gang, and I hope she's better. The Christmas evening with the Salvation Army to be held tonight in Benburb Presbyterian Church has been cancelled. See, people shouldn't be cancelling things now because it's thawing out there. It's a whole different world out there. The snow will be off the ditch by this time tomorrow. Lisburn Historical Quarter Arts Group invites you to a concert Christmas. The artists are Susan Boyd, soprano. It's not Susan. Oh, no, Boyle. Alan McClure. Elizabeth Bicker. A Sciolto Chamber Choir taking place in Lisburn Cathedral this evening at 7:30 p.m. Admission is free. Free. I can't talk today. Do you notice that for some reason? Tell Jerry the Highwayman did the best version of the song that goes on, Road Goes On Forever. No, they didn't. The gentleman who has got that copy of that particular version of The Road Goes On Forever by the gentleman in question is called Anthony Crotty. And he writes to me and he said, I hope to deliver your CD on Monday the 13th. I will bring it personally to you after 12 o'clock. I've heard you slag me this past few days. No, I'm just mentioning how slow you are.
Angela.
Liverpool Calling, in your stash of John Lennon covers, do you have I Want to Hold Your Hand by Teresa Carpio? If you haven't heard that version, YouTube it. It's beautiful. Some of the Jim Sturgis covers are good too. By the way, Naked Lennon was on BBC Three last night. I saw Naked Lennon the first time it was on. I didn't like it at all.
No.
Because I couldn't believe the character. What's his name?
He was very good at him. But
he didn't look right.
I thought he looked right.
No, he didn't look right. Did you see Nowhere Boy?
No, you asked me that already.
I know. You didn't see it, though.
What about Angela?
Angela, I would like to say a big hello to a great friend of my mother, Molly. Oh, I've already done that.
Angela.
Okay. Don't be so impatient. Good morning, Angela.
Good morning, Jerry.
How are you today?
I'm fine, thank you.
Notice how I can be nice. Well, it's not too bad. The worst of it is over.
Well, so to say, yeah.
It's all over. What can we do for you today?
I need your help. I'm representing a youth theatre company, Fusion Theatre from Lisburn.
Yes.
It's a cross-community theatre company. And in February, we're putting on Beauty and the Beast. And what we need, you'll laugh, but it's 32 silver tankards. At least 32 silver tankards.
I'm not laughing.
No. 32
silver...
Yeah, well, I did when the director shouted over to me last night. Just, I need 32 silver tankards and a throne-shaped chair for the Beast.
A throne-shaped chair for the Beast? It'll be a big chair.
It will be a big chair.
32 silver tankards and a big chair for a Beast.
Mm-hmm.
I'll see if Nolan's using his.
Now,
maybe lend you his BBC throne. All right, then. So where is this again, did you say?
Well, it's a Fusion Theatre Company in Lisburn, and I have given my number, my mobile number, to Emma.
You may as well cast a bun to a bear.
Are you in bad form this morning?
I'm not in bad form. I'm just surrounded by incompetence.
All right, okay.
I do my best to make the people happy.
You see, it's important.
It's important to me that the listeners are happy and they bring in here in good faith.
Yeah.
And they hear in my voice that I'm a real person. They know that I'm a man of the people.
Oh, they'll be much happier when they come to see Being in the Beast in February. Much happier.
They will be, of course.
Oh, they will, yeah.
You see, when they listen to Nolan, you see, he says he's a man of the people, but they know he's not.
Oh, true.
They know he's just lying
truly
to them.
Yourself,
but I am a man of the people, but the point is, I don't have the support that Nolan has. Nolan's a charlatan, and he's surrounded by great help. I'm a genuine saint and surrounded by, well, people who don't care.
No.
Anyway, 32 silver tankards and a big throne for a beast.
Yes, please.
Where are you going to get a throne for a beast at this time of night?
Well, could I get one from the BBC? Do you think they would hire me one?
Not
even hire. We have no money. We can't hire anything. We're looking for a beast.
All right, then. Well, maybe somebody's got a throne at home.
Yeah. With gold trimming.
All right, silver tankards.
Yes.
See, people might hesitate to give you 32 silver tankards. What you want is something that looks like a silver tankard. You don't necessarily want a silver tankard.
Yes, well,
this being show business, after all. All right, then.
And well, it's just a lend of. We will return them.
She wants EPNS tankards.
What does EPNS mean?
No idea.
I know.
Like
electroplated
nickel steel.
Well,
yeah.
Yeah. Fred Spoons and his EPNS.
Okay.
Electroplated nickel steel.
Yeah.
All right, then. Well, when you do a morning program like this, you pick up loads of shards of useless
information.
That can be sprayed out at parties. That's why I'm always alone in the kitchen at parties.
Bored into death.
Indeed, I'm a great bore. All right, then. Thank you very
Listen,
much.
Thanks for your help, Jerry. Thank
Bye.
You. Thanks. Bye.
The Bee Gees, Paperback Writer.
John's in Newry, then, if you want to go to John in Newry.
Hello, John. Hello, John.
Hi, Jerry. How you doing?
I'm all right, except I have to bring out that CD and wipe it. No. Look at it. Look at it, for God's
sake. It sounded rubbish anyway.
No, I'm going to play this now. I'm going to play it again. You can't let this go. If you announce to the people that they want to hear Paperback Writer by the Bee Gees, I'll try it again. I'll just try it once again. No, not now, but I'll try it when I finish talking to you. And if it doesn't work, I'll take it off again. All right, then. How are you today?
I'm fine. I'm all right, Jerry. I was just wondering if you could find... There was two wee things, just if you could... I wanted to go and see Steve Forbert last night up in the Eric Glen.
Oh, was he there last night?
Aye.
Oh, dear.
No, I couldn't get out with the weather. And the last time he came, it was on a Tuesday night, and I went on his website on the Wednesday to see when he was coming back to Ireland, and he'd played in Newry, which is a stone, you know, which is where I live. He played the night before in Newry Town Hall. I couldn't believe it. I missed him by one day.
Do you know the most amazing thing? Steve Forbert is probably one of the greatest singer-songwriters America has ever produced. But for some reason, his management isn't great. I'm not talking about the Northern Ireland management. You never know when he's here. His publicity machine... I mean, Daniel O'Donnell's got a better publicity machine than him. And Daniel O'Donnell, you couldn't be bothered with him. Like, everywhere you go, you know where he is. But Steve Forbert, you always miss him. It's terrible.
Yeah. Anyway, I was hoping maybe he'd rescheduled it because of the weather last night. That's what I was wondering, did he go ahead and play? Because he might have cancelled it for a night or two, you know.
Well, maybe somebody would let us know. Where was he supposed to be? The Eric Glen, was it?
The Eric Glen, aye.
Okay,
yeah.
did Steve Forbert appear in the Eric Glen last night? And if not, is he going to appear soon? I would say he probably would have appeared because there'd be no difficulty. People are getting around Belfast last night. Not really, you know.
The other person has hung up.
It was bad in Newry,
Sorry about that.
There was something else just before I go, Jerry. What about William Shatner's Lucy in the Sky with Diamonds? Any chance of playing that?
Yes, I have that. I'll play that.
Brilliant.
I'll play that after this, but try and play the Bee Gees Paperback Writer, okay?
Thanks very much.
Bye. Bye.
All the best. Bye.
I'm going to try this now. Hold on a second. This is very tricky. You see,
what do you mean it's very tricky?
It's very tricky. That's what I'm saying. You don't know what I'm doing. You don't know what I'm doing.
What?
You don't know what I'm doing.
Welcome, press welcome.
My hands are a blur as they fly across the machinery.
Is this it now?
Eleanor Rigby.
Ah, see,
it's the wrong one.
Yes, go. It's back one. It's back one.
Hold on a minute. Stop it.
Waits at the window.
Take him off.
Stop it.
Close his fader.
Hold on a second, will you?
It's the one before.
It's not the one before. How do you know?
Well, it has to be because it jumps forward.
It jumps forward?
Yes.
Hold on a second. Let me take this out. You see, these...
If you cue it up and pre-fade it, whenever you close the fader, it jumps forward.
Hold on a second.
What number is it?
Just a minute. Hold on a second.
Are they not numbered?
They are. I mean, it's all complicated. Look, you made me flustered now. Hold on a second.
Right.
I'm on the wrong thing.
What do you mean?
It's number three I'm looking for. Hold on a second.
What number did you play?
Never mind. I'm trying the best I can. Right. What do we do here?
I think it jumped forward.
It jumped forward.
Well, that's what I said to you.
Did you say that?
So it must be. If you played four, it must be three.
I don't know what has happened here. Something has happened here. Hold on a second.
Is it queuing up?
It's not queuing up. Hold on a second.
Look, many times we have to hold on a second.
Just hold on a second then. What am I doing?
Right.
Seven. No, I've lost. I'm lost here.
Look, take your time. Your time. That's it. Take your time. You want the Bee Gees.
I want.
What's that noise?
It's my telephone, which is on the desk.
Right. And so you want the Bee Gees.
Just a minute.
Singing.
Just looking at it.
Singing what?
Hold on a minute.
What is the song?
I've lost it now.
What's the song we're looking for?
I can't remember now. I've lost everything. Hold on a second. Just stay with me a moment. It's very important.
Paperback Writer.
Yes, Paperback Writer.
The Bee Gees.
By the Bee Gees. Hold on a second. Right. I might have to play something else, you know.
Why?
Because, you know, people are fed up listening to me trying to find the thing. What about Day Tripper by Mae West? What?
Can you not get...
I'll get it. Hold on a second. I don't want
to hear a man shouting Kris Kristofferson.
Has he got Kris Kristofferson singing it? Him in there. What's he talking about then? Nobody has anything. Hold on a second.
Look, there's people coming in now to help you.
I don't know. I don't want anybody in. Get out. I don't want anybody here. I want to do
it
myself.
There's a man coming in to help you put on a CD.
I don't want help.
I wonder what people are thinking.
I don't know what they're
this.
Thinking. I'll tell you what I'm going to play
what
them.
Are people.
I'm going to play them.
No, please. Wait. How many CDs have you got?
Ten.
How many CDs of Beatle covers have you got?
Ten.
You haven't ten.
I have ten. I'm going to play this one now. Give me time to think. Because it's saying welcome again. You see, whenever it goes wrong, it goes welcome. I can't understand why any of this happens at all. But play this one. And I'll get back to them.
Who's that?
I don't know. Whatever it is. Oh, it's The Happenings. Here, there and everywhere. Oh, you couldn't listen to that. No, no.
Love is love, though we may be blind. Love is here to stay, and that's enough to make you mine, babe. Be the only one. Love me all the time, babe. We'll go on and on. Someday we're dreaming deep in love, not a lot to say. Then we will remember the things we said today. I'm just a lucky kind. Love to hear you say that love is love, though we may be blind. Love is here to stay, and that's enough to make you mine, babe. Be the only one. Love me all the time, babe. We'll go on and on. Someday we're dreaming deep in love, not a lot to say. Then we will remember the things we said today. Then we will remember the things we said today.
Things We Said Today, and that's Mary McCassin. That's a good version of that. A number of people have rung and sent me emails to say that Steve Forbert did indeed play in the Errigal Inn last night and was packed out and was a great night and was brilliant. It was the last night of his tour and he may not be back for a while. So if you missed him, that's it. So he was there. There we go. Hello, good morning.
Hello.
Yes, who's that?
Oh, Jerry, good morning.
Yes, good morning. Who's that? Sorry.
Jerry, this is Jim Bradley from Newry.
Yes, Jim, how are you today?
I've spoken to you before, Jerry.
Yes.
Jerry, you played a track earlier on by Kimmy Roach.
Yes.
And Sean says you can't find him. The original.
Sorry?
Sean says you couldn't find it and he wasn't going to go and look for it.
That's
so
right.
So, very kindly, I'll come into your assistance because I have it.
You have it, have you?
I have you introducing it.
You have me introducing it?
Yes.
On what kind of machine? Some kind of strange machine that you have there? What
no, it's just on a C90.
Ah. No, but you see, I don't want me introducing it. What I want is the actual record itself. You
well,
see,
I can play the whole thing to you now.
Oh, no, it's okay, but you probably won't... The quality will not be acceptable.
Excuse me, Jim.
Hello,
Jim is here, Jerry, to point out to you, you said on air that you never played it and you don't remember playing it. And Jim has got a recording of you playing it, and that's why Jim wants to prove to you that you actually played it.
Well, thanks for putting him through.
Yes, so that's all. So just a wee snippet
of it. No, Sean, it's not that. I just want... I'm very surprised, actually, because last Friday night past, I was with Kimmy Rose in the Bronte Centre.
Yes, yes.
With my friend.
Yes, indeed,
and
yes.
And she asked about you.
Yes.
And she wanted to know why you weren't there.
Why, I wasn't there?
Yes.
Oh, yeah, that's right. I think I promised I would be there.
Yes.
You know, that kind of hollow promises you make.
It wasn't very happy because every other really bizarre Adam is there. Why are you?
You had another engagement, Mr. Anderson. It was,
well, that's right.
Snow,
that's, sorry, I forgot about that. Yes, I was elsewhere on that particular night.
She said to me, she forgive you on this occasion.
You see, one of the things that you must never do, and this is a thing that perhaps people do not realise, whenever you're a celebrity like me, Sean doesn't realise this because he doesn't know what it's like.
I know.
You never, ever go to anyone else's gigs.
No.
Because then you're a punter. You see, because whenever, I mean, for instance, say Brian Kennedy, just pick off a topic, supposing he's playing somewhere, right?
Yeah.
Now, Brian Kennedy would be coming in here and I'd be talking to Brian and he'd say, why don't you come along to the gig tonight? And I'd say, yeah, of course. He knows in the bottom of his heart
I don't go.
That there's no way I'm going. And do you know why he knows why I'm not going? It's because when he has finished his songs, right, he will go down and maybe perhaps sign some books and sign some CDs and talk to all the people who come to him. And they'll be all up saying, hello, Brian, oh, we love you, we like this. You see, he doesn't want to see me standing there. He doesn't want to see me standing there.
Yeah, Gary, I understand
because he's,
all
he's
that.
Doing he's doing his shtick, you see.
But there's a slight variance here because I also do the same thing as you.
What is that?
I am a radio presenter.
You're a what?
I'm
a radio presenter, are you? What station do are you on?
Well, it's not really worth it, put that way to you.
What a wonderful opportunity to advertise. Come on.
I'm not advertising.
But you, well, I know you're not, but why aren't you?
I'll put this way to you. It's a commercial radio station based in Newry.
Yeah, but there's no reason why you can't mention it. Why not?
Well, because I've had her on, and she, the first time she came then, wasn't there, and she appeared, what?
Hey, well, you see, she's a lovely girl.
A lovely person.
She's and a beautiful person now. I have a lot of time for Kimmy Rhodes. I think she's beautiful. Person. Did you meet her son as well? He's lovely.
I did indeed.
Yeah, very nice guy.
Brilliant guitarist too.
Unbelievable. Did you see his guitar, did you? Do you know much? Did you see that guitar he had? Do you know that guitar is worth a fortune? Of 10 fortunes that guitar is worth. You couldn't buy that guitar.
He lifted the accordion. He could play keyboards. What a talented kid.
I know.
Brilliant. And I was really surprised you weren't there. Because well, spent...
I don't go to people's gigs. I don't go. Because you...
Oh, Brian Darcy was there.
I know, but he's not like an ordinary person.
You weren't there.
He's a priest. He was there in case something happened to her.
You weren't there.
I wasn't there, no. But you see, you never go to... No, I've explained this before, but I'm sorry I didn't go. And I don't want you to play me introducing the song that I said I didn't have.
Do you want to hear a song or not?
Oh, go ahead, then. For God's sake, people playing your stuff down the phone. I'm surprised you tolerate this.
Well, whenever you are finished, there's a man who needs your help urgently. He's lost.
I'm sure he does.
No, Graham.
Just give it a second.
Graham's on too.
We're giving you all the time you need, for God's sake.
But you won't play at all.
No, don't play at all. We'll have to turn him off.
People out there in their homes. That's why we're here. That's why they built a big studio with a roof on it. It's called the BBC.
You just to be laughing at yourself.
Life. Oh, no.
Here's a penny for... Where's Willie Nelson?
He was in line.
Makes you smile. Every diamond.
Where's Willie?
Where's Willie Nelson?
And Willie should have been in there.
He should have been.
Give him a chance.
Stop heckling.
He had a chance.
He had every chance to get in there.
Love and happy.
He has to sing now.
He better sing now, or else it's a sham.
That's it.
All right, sorry, then, man. Okay.
Right. That's okay.
Take it when you go.
All right, then, thank you. You see, let's see what happens when they start playing.
Okay.
They won't turn it off.
You can say cheerio now, do you?
Cheerio now.
That's it.
You see, it always happens when you play a record, they never turn it off. We had to turn that off there.
That's it. Now, could you turn to Graham? Graham
I'll turn to Graham.
He needs your help. He needs your help urgently.
Graham, hello, good morning.
How are you?
I believe you. I'm fine, thanks. Do you need my help urgently?
Everybody needs your help at some time, Jay.
I hope so.
So
well, what is the subject of your help?
I'll tell you, I've got a small problem. Well, I've got a major problem with my job. I have 8 sheep that went astray down at the edge of the River Ban at Port Ganoan.
Yes, yes.
And I've looked for them sort of every day this past week, and I haven't come across them.
It's very hard to see sheep in the snow, isn't it?
It's hard to see them in the snow, is right. That's the problem I think I have come across.
Yeah.
And I just want to know if any of your listeners that saw 8 stray sheep in their land or any gardens or any fields around them that they shouldn't be there and maybe they could...
Okay, because they're probably discombobulated by the conditions and, you know, the old grass is not as frequent, is not as freely available as it normally is and they might panic a bit. So, tell me, what's the nearest settlement to where those sheep would be?
Well, they're near the River Ban. They're just grazing on ground beside the wild duck. Pub and Port Ganoan. I suppose you've probably been there a time or two, Jerry.
I played there. Somebody mentioned that to me the other day, and I did a gig there years ago. Oh, I know exactly what's lovely there. All right, then. So keep an eye out there. How many sheep do you say you've lost?
8 sheep, 7 females and a male.
Hmm. Well, they'd probably stick together then, will they? Do they normally do that?
Stick together.
Okay. All right, then. People down there.
Divorce 4 sheep.
People down there in the vicinity of Port Ganoan, keep an eye out for 7 or 8 sheep. Okay.
Okay, thank you.
All right, then, thank you. Bye. Bye. Bye.
Should you not ask them if they had any markings on them or anything? No, did they not put a coloured dye on them to identify them or anything? You didn't really go into that at all, you know. Again, you're not firing all cylinders this morning. Are you all right? Everything all right? Waterworks all right? Bowels all right? Did you sleep all right last night?
I'm a bit constipated.
I thought that you'd look strange today. You're not yourself.
This thing's wrong. I don't want to talk about it.
I'm not happy.
He can tell. You're not caring this morning at all.
I don't give two hoots.
No, it's all about you. It's all about you and your old blocked bowel.
I never mentioned my blocked bowel. Nothing to do with that.
It's higher up.
That's A Day in the Life by Jeff Beck. Hello, good morning, Geordie.
Hello, Jerry.
Well, some people are saying that your the forecast for a bitter, bitter winter some months back was entirely on the money and entirely accurate.
Yes.
And people are congratulating you on your weather forecasting skills.
Good.
If only they said the professionals would be as far-reaching and as all-seeing as yourself.
Well, I said, Jerry, well, the bushes, the holly trees, the watery, they're all loaded with berries.
People in the meteorological office are dealing with readings and all kinds of stuff, but you watch the animals.
Yes.
Talk to the animals, grunt and squeak and squawk with the animals, and they will talk to you.
Backside to the wind.
That's right, Tandragee. Tandragee.
Ah.
Tandragee is Irish for arse to the wind.
Ah, a town with no hoof.
Well, what is your forecast? Is it a thaw now?
Oh, it'll last 5-6 weeks, yes.
Oh, no, it won't. It's your thaw started today.
Well, not down here.
Really? Is it still gripped in icy conditions to your area?
Donnie the goat then and Whitey the goat then all closed up.
All what?
All closed up in the wee bar.
Excuse me.
Oh, tell me this, Jerry, before I go.
Yes?
Maybe that's why you're a bit grumpy.
I don't know why I'm grumpy. It's just something's not right.
Did you get your with the food allowance? £250.
Well, it's difficult for me to say.
What?
You see, what's happened, I've got this terrible cold.
Did you get it?
I'm going to do something revolutionary with it. I'm going to buy coal with it.
Well, that's what I'm doing.
I know, but sure,
I've got mine.
Who else is doing
that? But only one know did you get yours.
I can't say. I can't give away personal details like that.
When am I expecting this parcel from Jerry on this?
I'll tell you what I'm doing. I'm getting together your Christmas parcel as we speak.
Good, I knew you would.
It's very difficult to know what to include. I know what to leave out. But
well, the
it's
last
difficult.
Time you sent one was the cocktail shake. Well, you didn't.
Look at the wear you got.
Look at the wear.
Look at the wear you got out of that.
I still have it.
I know you have. All right, Geordie. Listen, I'll be back to you shortly. I want to talk to him.
All the
here.
Best, sir.
All right, see you. Bye. Is that man on now?
Michael.
Good morning, Michael.
Good morning, Jerry.
Michael, sorry to keep you. I know you're expecting to be on earlier, but this program is so confusing, even for me, and I'm the presenter.
Not at all.
A concert now. It's been coming off next Friday, and you want to sell some tickets.
That's right. It's called The Spirit of Christmas, and it's a group of us I've got together with muscular dystrophy, and we've called ourselves the Muscle Tears.
Yes.
And we've decided to run this concert in Willowfield Parish Church next Friday on the 17th at 7:30, hosted by your good self.
I must declare an involvement, and I want you to tell the people that I'm getting no money whatsoever for this.
Absolutely nothing. No, just your time, which we very much appreciate. Thank you, Jerry.
And what a lovely place that Willowfield Church is.
It is. Gorgeous church. Really is nice.
How old is that?
It's over 100 years old, I believe, Jerry. Yes. Well,
it's beautiful because it's a great combination of the old and the new. It's all kind of mixed in together. It's really nice. I love it.
It is. Yep,
so it's next Friday, so,
next Friday, the 17th at 7:30.
Okay.
And we're having performers with the likes of Your Music School, Shine, Michelle De Silver. We have Christmas readings and carols from the likes of Olivia Nash, who a lot of people will know as Ma and Give My Head Peace.
That's right.
Gavin Andrews from the BBC Sports.
What's he going to do?
He's going to do a reading as well.
Yeah.
We have assembly members Chris Little and Don Purvis, and they will be doing the same thing. So there'll be candlelit carols and singing. Tickets are £8.50.
Yes.
And people under 16, £4. And we'd very much like people to come along for the evening.
Come along, and as I say, I'll be comparing. I'm looking forward to that. I was down one day, and you're lovely people down there, and I have to say, they're really nice people. And
thank
you. I turned into Hugo. Did you hear me turn into Hugo there? Did you hear that?
Mm-hmm.
It's just an automatic transformation. I don't know what happened. I have to stop that. No, but I really enjoyed being down there. So that's next Friday. Not tomorrow night, but next Friday.
Next Friday.
And Willowfield Parish Hall, which is down the Woodstock Road, of course.
Woodstock Road, East Belfast.
And it's for muscular dystrophy.
For muscular dystrophy campaign, yes.
All right.
And tickets, Jerry, people can get them on telephone number 0845.
0845.
872.
872.
9058.
9058.
Or come along in the evening. If they come early enough, there will be tickets for sale at the door.
Okay, and come in, and I'll be there, and Gavin and Olivia will be there, and we'll come in and say hello.
Yes, absolutely.
And
there's light refreshments afterwards for people if they want a cup of tea or something to eat or drink. Yeah.
And it starts at 7:30.
Starts at 7:30 next Friday.
Okay, then so we'll have a chat again before the Friday week, and so I'll see you then. Okay.
Lovely. Thank you very much indeed.
Not at all. It's a pleasure.
You.
Bye.
Okay. All the best.
Bye.
What would you do if I sang out of tune? Would you stand up and walk out on me? Bend me your ears and I'll sing you a song. Lord, I'll try not to sing out of key. I'd get by with a little help from my friends. I'm gonna try with the help from my friends. I get high with the help from a good friend. What do you do when your love is away? Does it worry you to be on your own? And how it's the end of a day. Are you sad because you're on your own? No, I get by with a little help from friends. I'm gonna try with the help from friends. I get high with the help from friends. Do you need anybody? Well, I must say that I do need me someone to love. Could be anybody. Oh, Lord, I just need me someone to love. Someone to love. Do you believe in a love at first sight? Yes, I'm certain that it happens all the time. And what do you see when you turn out the light? I can't tell you, but it sure enough must be mine. Lord, I get by with a little help from a friend. I get high with the help from a friend. I just may die with a little help from my friend. I get by with a little help from my friend. With help from my friend. Come along now, won't you help me, my friend?
Something the way she moves. We got an answer, but we mind your time, Dave.
Attracts me like no other lover. Something in the way she woos me. I don't want to leave her now. You know I believe in how. Somewhere in her smile, she knows that I don't need no other lover. Something.
Now, who's that?
That's not, no, don't tell me. Listen. Sounds like Telly Savalas.
Yes! A lot of people don't know who Telly Savalas was. He played the part of Kojak.
You're asking me, will my love grow? I don't know. I don't know. You stick around, now it may show. I don't know, I don't know.
Oh, you couldn't listen to that, could you?
That's awful.
That's Telly Savalas. Mm. And here's a person complaining about the music. I hate your music. It's at that point that I changed the city beat. More modern music, please. We're not all 104.
What about
I'm playing Lawrence, this music because of a particular reason. It's a particular day today, and I'm playing music. It's kind of old music, I know, but it's just a day. I don't do this every day.
It's a day after the event.
The day after the event. I think it's better to do things the day after the event, because when you do it the day what the event is on, people are fed up. Surprise, surprise! The selfish, self-centred Anderson cuts short certain colours.
What about the Bob Dylan information the man's looking?
Bob Dylan information, what was that?
Well, Lawrence McNally's looking.
What's he looking?
The Bob Dylan, Hard Rain's Gonna Fall. The one with all the big orchestra playing.
Hard Rain's Gonna Fall? And that's the Tokyo Symphony Orchestra? Tokyo Symphony Orchestra. You can get that if you log into Amazon.co.uk or indeed Amazon.com. And perhaps you can log on to Amazon Japan if you speak Japanese. Or if you can write or read Japanese, log on to Amazon.co.uk and tap in Bob Dylan. Hard Rain's Gonna Fall, Tokyo Symphony Orchestra, and you'll find out how to get that. Dear Jerry, would you please play something nice for my daughter Val? Her husband is in hospital at the moment. I will certainly. Please play some Ciara Connolly. I haven't heard from Ciara Connolly for a while. I wonder what she's doing. Jerry, had to sit down and roll a fat one with a cup of tea during that programme today. We won't explain that. There are innocent people out there who are eating toast. It's Humphrey McGonigal here. For the love of Nolan, please tell him to stop playing inferior Beatle covers and try the real thing. Well, you see, I enjoy playing the covers because you don't hear them. What that was that you played after the news? Sound like a poor man's Wagner. Wagner, not Wagner as in Ride of the Valkyries, but Wagner as in X Factor. Somebody said to me the other day, there's a program on BBC4 called Stephen Fry and Wagner, right? Mm-hmm. And the person said to me, Stephen Fry making a programme about your man in the X Factor. What about a wee bit of Bill Shatner? Oh, what's a red scent? No, I'm supposed to play Bill Shatner, I forgot. Please play Give Peace a Chance. Anthony Toner has just released a tribute to John Lennon called Me and John Lennon, and you, if you get a chance, play it. I never heard of that. Hey, Bucket Bick, quit with the requests. You're getting more like Hugo. Oh, grievance.
These are all text messages.
Thanks for that.
No, but I guess people are wondering because they say you don't read them out and say, I don't give them to you. I just want to make this absolutely clear that you've got them.
Yes, Steve Forward was here. He often appears as part of the Real Music Club programme. You can keep in touch via their website. Is Turkey Neck on work experience? You and Sean are like two little boys fighting about a toy. A toy. Your professionalism knows no bounds. You see, and you ask me why I don't read out the text messages.
You're the very boy, it said, warts and all.
Could you please announce that the evening for members of the Orange Order with 50 years service in Portadown tonight has been cancelled due to the weather? Right, I'm going to play a little snippet of this to finish us off because this is one of the best ones.
Here comes the sun, little darling. Here comes the sun, I say. It's all right. It's all right.
Nina Simone.
Here comes the sun, little darling. Here comes the sun, I say. It's all right.
Can't hear as much of that as we would have liked. Time running out. Back tomorrow. Cara Dillon will be in here tomorrow morning.